one day, like, I really want to start a program that is only designed around teen moms. It's going to be called Mothers Helping Mothers, because I'm a mom helping a mom, but actually we're mothers helping mothers. But I was a teen mom. So I had my first son at 16 years old. Teen moms have come to me and needed daycare, and that's, to me, what I specialize in, because I've been doing it since 2000. So I've set them up with other daycares, or I actually opened up a house in 2009 in Bexley, Ohio, and I started taking in girls with support, someone that could be their advocate when they go down to Job and Family Services, someone that can help them find stable housing so that they wouldn't receive evictions after evictions because they did housing and then they didn't have a strategy plan on their goals on how they would pay their rent. So we have different rooms throughout the building. One of the rooms is a food pantry, and that is a place where if they're needing of anything at home, they can come receive it. Whatever it is that we have, they can get that on a daily basis. We have a classroom setting. That classroom is designed for parenting classes, education classes, nutrition classes, classes to come from a mom to a mother, and also a mother to a student. So if they come to us with a greater need, we would just pack up a bag, you know, count what we gave them, and then they can just have that for free without using their points towards used material. We have another room, which is a safe haven. It's a place that if they just found out they was pregnant, or if they just need to get away, some of them have environments where they just can't stand being at it once they get out of school area. But that lobby area is designed to look like a home, so that when they come here, they don't feel like they're at an actual location that is providing services to them, that they feel like the structure here is people that love them and care for them, and that it's surrounded, you know, generally someone that who's really cares. So that's why we set the building up the way it is. For potential sponsors and donors, if you're looking for a worthy cause, this is a place where it's needed. We all talk about the crisis, and we all talk about teen mothers and babies and what we can do to help. Here's a group of people, and here's an organization that is giving their time and their love and their efforts into seeing our girls grow. So you can reach us or contact us or call us, looking for teachers, counselors, mentors. If you were a teen mother when you were young and now you're successful and you're doing things in life, this is a perfect opportunity for you to come out and talk to them. Spend time with them. You can give hours. You can give contribution donations. We're also starting a sponsor program. You can sponsor one of our girls. It'll help them succeed through our program. You can sponsor our store, sponsor our food pantry. So just please give us a call at 614-523-3990, mhmteen.org. You can also reach us there on our connection line. If you are having problems and you're scared to tell someone, you can call here. We'll link you up with someone, get you a mentor, and get you the help that you need. You can look us up by calling 614-523-3990.